Time for another episode of the Thought Project, just so you know. And today I'm going to be starting out with the song Zoot Suit Riot.
Whispering in the trees, it's two cities and they're on leave. Pipes and chains and swinging hands. Who's your daddy? Yes, I am. Bad cat came to play. Now you can't run fast enough. You best stay away when the pushers come to shove.
Okay, so that's enough of that song for today. I'm not gonna do the whole thing in a whole dance like I did on Friday. I hope you all enjoyed that much. That was actually my hat from when I was made Queen of the Mystic Crew, which is the Louisiana Association for basically, well, DC Mardi Gras. It's an association event. You can look it up. It's really prestigious. I was very happy to have been given the honor in the year 2020. And then I ended up being the reigning person for that title for 2 years because of COVID, because they didn't do an event the next year in 2021. So anyways, and I was given that title because of all my years of advocacy and caring about issues that were valuable to the association. And when I got the title, they offered me a crown, but I decided to go ahead with the hat. And a lot of it had to do with the fact that I looked at how the event was configured, the kind of people that were involved, and they had a lot of princesses, younger women who would wear crowns, like teenagers, women in their early 20s, and then the older women generally, or whoever was the queen, would wear something that was more sort of fun, less serious than a crown. So, and there's tons of pictures of me at the event actually on Facebook. It was a really great time. And I got into it for a number of years also with a friend of mine. So anyways, I just thought we'd open with that and the song Zoot Suit Riot. As far as the history of Zoot Suits in the U.S., I thought I might cover that for a second. Zoot Suits were actually associated with Russian mafia activity. The song itself is just about dealing with that. It's like you're stuck in the middle of whatever this is. So you're going to, you know, it's a song about just dancing your way through it. And what's interesting is how Zoot Suits can look today, because if you see a woman in a really loud suit, it's actually meaning that she's either being dressed by somebody who's a part of that network or is actually one herself. In the 80s, those suits reemerged as what used to be shown on women as the really big jackets. You probably remember with the really loud plaid prints and stuff. So if you see that, you know, especially in the past, and sort of trace this through the Zoot Suit, that's actually where it came from. And some people trace it back to Harlem, which would be incorrect and unfair, I think, to African Americans, actually. So, as far as the economy, who was I think Senator Blinken today, not Senator Blinken, sorry, Secretary Blinken, of the State Department released a really long statement that was sort of nebulous on China and Taiwan, saying that the U.S. was asking for relations to stay exactly the same for there being no aggression on the part of China, and then for the Chinese to try to move forward with better relations with the U.S., which they basically denied, at least in one specific key issue, which apparently does nothing for our economy. I don't know about you, I'm not really interested in the U.S. engaging in huge conflicts with China, personally. I think, you know, the freedom of Taiwan and Hong Kong, the other countries in that region, is really important. It'd be really nice if China didn't become aggressive with them, but China's kind of aggressive, so I don't think there's a whole lot of commentary I even want to give on it. And I just noticed that this morning, it was all over the news. And so we're gonna go ahead with the rest of the show just after that small note. The situation with beer, apparently, somebody put out a really fake article and got it just spread all over the place last week, claiming that a beer I've never even heard of or drank, and wouldn't even bother with, called Modelo, I guess, was supposed to be the number of beer in the U.S. That's actually not true. I looked up the research and the numbers on which beers are actually the most popular in the U.S. That is very clearly a drink called Guinness out of Ireland. Actually, it's a stout. So it's an extremely thick stout type of beer, and the process for making it is really different for pilsners. And it's something that people even sometimes have drank as a meal replacement. The Irish actually did that at one point in their lives. So, and then the other really popular beers are Blue Moon, Sam Adams, and Corona. And then remember that craft beer is actually the most popular kind of beer of all in the U.S. For people who bother to buy it or still drink it. I actually don't bother to buy beer at all, because I am completely gluten-free, so anything I drink is going to be in the category that's actually more popular than any of the beers, which is ciders and seltzers, right? The replacement for beer. You skip all that stuff because it has wheat, and then you're drinking ciders or seltzers if you even bother anymore, you know? So it's the same kind of category of drink, but completely different substance, completely different ingredients. So, anyways, now, moving along, I just thought it was interesting because that's when people come up with terms like fake news, or, you know, say what the heck's going on with the media, or stuff that's been paid for and placed and then clearly being driven through SEO optimization, paid hits. I do need to do a history lesson today, and we are going to have to go through this. So you're probably wondering, and I had to put this down myself, when you look back on some of the things I discussed, one issue that does have to be seriously discussed is that Kendrick, because I decided to give him a name, and his company, he very clearly told everybody that he only hired people who are Russian of Russian ancestry. They could look like a different ethnic group or be part of a different ethnic group or racial group partially, but they had to at least be partially Russian. And he said that going back to the days at Luther, and I have no idea if he's changed his mind now or had therapy or whatever happened to him exactly. You know, we never discussed it again, even though I just saw him again in Charlottesville, but we managed to not argue, which is good. But the reality is that his company was clearly only employing people who are Russian, and the people like myself who were not Russian were not getting paid for their work. So that issue still hasn't been resolved. By the way, do you like my nails? They're red and white. I have a story about that. Also, do you like my shirt? I've had it for like 20 years. So anyways, and there's no like signal with that. It's just a shirt that I think is cute and I've kept it. I thought it'd be fun to wear for the show. So, and we do need to discuss something though with the CIA that's been an issue, is that they've had a number of assets and they've been blamed for this repeatedly. And so I'm just going to go down to what the issue truly was, but I'm going to have to back up and tell you a story about Luther College in order for you to understand it. When I first got to Luther College and I was auditioning for the choirs, and I'm a very good singer and I'm very much somebody who belongs in a choir and thought I was coming to this school as part of being in the choir system, I auditioned for something my freshman year called Pika Corps, and their colors were red and white. Well, in the Russian culture, the traditional colors for marriage are actually red and white. That's what they have the women wear on their wedding night. And it's a little weird for a choir to be wearing that in public though, right? And when I auditioned for it, the director, who was a woman named Sandra Peter, and I'm giving out a real name because this needs to be known publicly, told me that she didn't want me to be in it because she didn't want me to be married to a Russian man because she was Russian and thought only Russian men should marry Russian women. Very ethnocentric. And I told her the truth. I said, I don't understand this conversation. I'm a young woman attending school and I'm just trying to go to school here. And she started talking about Kendrick and how she didn't want to be married to him. And I said, well, that's fine. I was already told that wasn't going to be happening anyways. And I don't know this person really. And he seems to be way too good of friends with Cersei and Wilhelm, who I actually don't like and want to get away from. And she told me that Pika Corps was actually only for women who were Russian, who were going to marry Russian men, which is one of the craziest things I've ever heard in my whole life. And I said, well, that's actually a form of racism. And I told her that day, and I was only 18 years old. I said, that's racist. I thought I was here to audition for a choir, which would be including people who were actually good singers. So Pika Corps was actually not a good choir because it only featured women that they were planning to have married off to Russian men from the school, meaning the school was a form of cult tied to the Russian government. And unfortunately, that is KGB, FSB behavior. If you can't keep up with talking speed, that's your problem. Now, here's the reality of that. There was another choir that was called Canary for the women, where they wore all black and they didn't wear robes. That's a bit like having a football team that doesn't actually wear uniforms or helmets, okay? They put these women out there. I was one of them. We wore all black and we sang and performed. And I only bothered with Canary for like 3/4 of the year and I just dropped it because it was so insulting and ridiculous because they made fun of all of us. That's how Russian the school was. That they actually made fun of American citizens and women who didn't actually fit into Pika Corps who sang in Canary. How dare any of us sing at all or even exist? Really, that's the attitude. And scarily enough, there was a number of women at the school that were attacked and killed, and A number of them were raped and beaten, and a number of us were labor trafficked for our artistic talents. And it all seemed to go back to profiting this company. You know, and my freshman year, I was very lucky to live with two women in a dorm who actually happened to be very, one of them actually was of Russian ancestry. The other one might have been as well, but they were Russian American women who protected me and kept me from getting hurt that year. And, you know, they would tell me don't go out at night at certain times and actually kept me safe. So it's important that story is known because the school was incredibly violent and strange. And it was a really scary place to live, actually. So where does this all play back into? And I need to note that there was another woman on the staff, Jackie Wilkie, who eventually was forced to retire, but it took until the 2010s to get retired, who told me flat out that we were all going to be trafficked, that we had to provide the information. One thing that saved my life is I'd openly said I didn't care to be married to some guy I didn't hardly know who was Russian, called Ketterick, that they could have their work company, but they didn't expect anything from me since they weren't planning to employ me or give me an actual employment contract or pay me, right? And she ended up telling me it wasn't going to matter because she had control of the CIA and she named off all these people that she knew at the CIA. So that was an issue with the CIA having a bunch of Russian assets who were clearly willing to violate intelligence laws in order to get people trafficked. Okay. So I went out to the DC area and I ended up working on all of this for my own sake as well as everyone else's because it was completely ridiculous. And the CIA has had a consistent problem with people I've named in the past, Buffalo Bill, Patricia, seriously, Wilhelm, the Swiss Miss, maybe even Kendrick himself, breaking in there and working there in jobs. And they've had a problem with a woman who's repeatedly been the head of HR, being an identified Russian asset, hiring people who worked for the Russian government instead of people who actually worked for the U.S. and protected Intel. So this is why there's a problem with the CIA, because the structure of it when it was originally formed was Russian and it had a lot of problems with it. And it's very, for some reason, it's been a place that the Russians have always been able to break into and get themselves rehired in. Because what I eventually found out through 19 years of research is that the U.S. government has actually been repeatedly firing this woman who's been running HR over at the CIA. And she actually comes back. And in some situations, people have even said that she was actually killed and showed up again. Meaning that they're actually sending back a completely different person in some costume. Because this woman's features and personality never change. The way she looks never changes. Well, people change. People age. I have, you know, lines from aging, right? I have different freckles and marks on me from aging. My hair color changes. My clothing styles change. Everything doesn't always look exactly the same because people change naturally and inevitably throughout the lifespan, even while revisiting certain styles and, you know, colors and events. You know, nothing ever looks exactly the same. So when someone always looks exactly the same, probably not even looking at the same person. Or you're looking at the exact same person who's clearly an asset. Either way, it means they're an asset because people change, even just in smaller amounts. So now you know that how strange the situation has become. What does any of this mean for U.S. citizens or anyone else in the U.S.? Well, it's important to understand here in the U.S. at least that you do not have to work for anybody for the government for free. Doesn't matter where they say they're from. They can't show up and say they're from the CIA and ask you to work for free. They can't show up from any other agency and ask you to work for free. This is the kind of stuff that drives the Department of Labor crazy and keeps them really busy. Same with DHS. And I will tell you, when I was living in Dubuque, Iowa, there were some problems with Patricia and Dan and Buffalo Bill posting false information claiming that people had to work for the CIA for free and that they're going to be asked to engage in actual, you know, projects and not be paid. And those projects actually are tied back to this company out in Hollywood. Now, how does this all play out? Well, the Department of Labor actually intervened even back in the 80s when I was a kid and sent people to explain to us what our rights were and told us that we didn't have to work for them for free and actually tried to engage in stopping the trafficking that was being set up and the lies that were being perpetuated. And unfortunately, one of the men who was a local Department of Labor employee, there was an attack on his family. And I don't mean a little attack. I mean, there was an actual weapon released. Somebody actually got one released. And unfortunately, it was an error on the part of the CIA not having control of their assets. And that's an issue that the agency still has to address. And that's why they've been downsized and are heavily monitored now at this point. And that's also a development of the rest of the U.S. government as a result. So I just want to make sure you know all that so you're not confused about who you really need to be upset with. There is an issue with both the FBI and the CIA having been structurally set up by people who are Russian, at least involved in the development of them, understanding them, and then putting their assets in. And, you know, we're nicely calling it a cabal at the FBI these days in the hearings. I love Senator Marsha Blackburn, by the way. I've met her a few times in my life. She's a wonderful woman, and she really gets the issues there. And that's just a nice way of saying there's some weird group that's inserted itself in the FBI that's clearly not interested in the American people or the protection of the U.S., and that's a problem. And I have no idea if those issues will ever be resolved. You may only end up with the dissolution of the FBI and the CIA as a result of it, understanding that they clearly do not actually handle as many issues or as much of the U.S. government or even national security as one would have been led to believe by media that's essentially been set up in many cases by Russians throughout the history of the U.S. Don't forget how much of the country club culture was actually set by people in the FSB and the KGB. And that's where you get the weird marriage arrangements and contracts. By the way, it's important to understand that women actually rank higher in the Russian FSB, KGB than the men do. So they can make orders and they can order the men around. So instead of saying, well, these big men, they're so dangerous, you need to start to look more at the fact that a lot of these women are actually running them. And they run them with signet systems and computers. So it's a war of technology there. And the radio signals in the U.S. and what they're used for is actually the main issue. Their military isn't that good. So, all I can say is, if any of this, you know, after what I just saw in Charlottesville, is if Kendrick is actually a victim in all this, or anybody else is involved with this agency, or people have known me, I'm talking about the company out in Hollywood, and you're feeling trapped, you know, there are ways out. But you have to get out of the cult mentality, and that requires some things that a lot of people don't necessarily want to do in giving up a certain way of life, and people don't always know how to do that. So, and the reality is that for other people judging it from the outside is they're going to say, well, this person made a whole lot of money off of a whole lot of people working for free and being abused. And there's been an awful lot of rape and murder involved in all this. So, interesting story came out over the weekend, just to keep you informed. China operates intel centers in the U.S. quietly. I've known this for 15, 16 years after living in the D.C. area and researching it. But the MSN website and then also Daily Caller are verified. So that's two completely different types of sources verified than you have me as a third source. And I got that information from years of research that, yeah, China's been operating intel centers. I'm pretty sure they have one around Charlottesville. Pretty sure. And you need to remember that the church that I thought I was a part of was not actually a church. That was actually an organization that literally had taken another church that was Scottish that had split, claimed to be putting the two parts back together and forming a new church, and it wasn't. They were actually running Russian intel centers as a church front all over the U.S. Now, have people left that church and left it very seriously because it's basically just KGB, FSB? Yes. The woman at the CIA, or claiming to be at the CIA, because maybe she never even really worked at the CIA either, in their HR department, or running their HR department, was actually a member of the national branch of that church in the D.C. area, and it's essentially a comm center for Russia. I have no idea if it's been shut down yet. I hope it has. Seriously. So, I'd love to tell you this is all classified. It's not. It's public knowledge. People have just been struggling with dealing with it all. So, just letting you know that. Just letting you know. In fact, Jackie Wilkie was difficult enough at Luther College that we started to make fun of her and said we thought she was actually married to Kendrick because she kept talking about the projects and things she was going to do with him and how wonderful it was going to be. And I finally said, I think you're his wife. You're Russian. You can speak Russian to each other. In fact, weirdly, the woman who ended up pushing her kid on him told me that they had to be together because the child could speak Russian. It turned out the child was actually part Russian and Peruvian. So in other words, it was still an act of an ethnocentrism for the marriage. It had to be Russian with Russian, right? Ethnocentric. There's nothing wrong with that if that's actually what you like, but it can't be at the expense and cost of other people, and it can't really be at the expense and cost of the U.S. government, and certainly not in favor of a cult. A violent cult? Is it tied to the Shining Path and its origins? No. Nope. And that's the point, that none of it actually has to do with marriage, it all has to do with money-making and weird economics and disrupting people's lives. But if you're ever anywhere in the U.S. and you see anything posted that says you're supposed to work for the government for free, that is fake. That is fake material. And you can report that as a violation of the U.S. government. Okay, impersonating cops, providing fake materials, like using the CIA logo without permission, DHS, the Department of Labor, any of the agencies, I don't care which one it is, even if it's the Postal Service, fake using their stuff without permission to lie like that is a federal offense and you can go to prison for it. You really can. So oftentimes people will just throw this stuff away and ignore it. You can report it to if you want, but you know, the reality is you need to remember as a U.S. citizen, someone living in the U.S., you do not have to work for the government for free, and nobody has the right to ask you to work for free, okay? I just want people to know that so they're not confused. Because this has been one of the strangest things I've ever seen, and I've had a number of friends over the years who worked in the government and the Department of Labor who had such a hard time over it all. So, anyways. I don't know. I'm just looking at all this other stuff. Yeah, I think we kind of got through it. You know, it kind of looks like, I think you need to know there was an event put on by DHS last year. They did a webinar where they talked about the fact that you're more than likely to be trafficked by somebody who claims work for the U.S. government or is in it than anybody else. And it's kind of important to know that because a lot of these people turn out to be assets. Every single one I ever found out was doing it was an asset. They're oftentimes tied to the Russian mafia, working with the Russian government or something. I don't know why they're so big on doing that, so gross, but that's just part of their culture. And it's part of the reason the U.S. has made such an effort to support the Ukraine, because it actually helps and supports the people in the U.S. Because we really don't want Russia to be empowered. They waste materials, money, people, everything. It's just, and the culture is just really backwards. I mean, do you think there's a possibility someone today is going to get really mad and be like, oh my gosh, she has red and white on. Oh look, she has a red and white mug. It doesn't mean she's going to marry a Russian man and steal him from us in our cult. Ugh. Who cares? It's ridiculous. It's weird. It's very disassociative too. So, and the reality is I'm just clearly wearing these colors because this is what I felt like doing and it was fun. And I bought the cup because I think it's fun. Yeah, it's for my middle initial, K. So, anyways, and I heard too many conversations from people that turned out when I traced their problems, because I did take time to empathize with some of them, that they were unhappy with the forced marriages and the arrangements and wanted out of them and wanted out of that lifestyle. And it was just really sad to hear because the behaviors and attitudes really hurt a lot of other people. And it's almost selfish to say that it's about you picking your contractual marriage or whatever. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous to involve other people, and it's ridiculous to put that on other people. And it's ridiculous to ask other people for money and to work for free and to not live their lives simply to support yours so you don't really have to work. And it's especially ridiculous to injure them or disable them, murder all of it, you know, the extremeness of it. By the way, since I saw Patricia and Buffalo Bill up in Saginaw, I'm going to tell you right now, I would not bother with a cheeseburger festival in Caseville. In fact, I'd be very careful about any of the festivals, but I would certainly not go to that one because I talked to a bunch of people about it and they all told me it's not very well policed. And so it's kind of unsafe. And those two, that's the kind of place they would go to cause some trouble. And they cause trouble in some places like that in the DC area and also out in LA. I think everyone's heard of Fry Fest and some of these other festivals have gone right along. Certainly the Cheeseburger Festival is not on that level, but any festival that's not well policed is going to be a really unsafe place to be in times like these. And that's one of them. So please take good care of yourself and be safe. I'm going to sing the lovely song by TLC from the 90s called No Scrubs, and I'm going to karaoke it, and I hope you really enjoy it. And I just want to say for the record, you know, no, nobody likes scrub men, and men can have money and still be scrubs because of the way they live and the way they conduct themselves. Actually, I do have to tell a little side story because I have a huge following among gay men. I know they like it when I sort of mouth off sometimes, so, and Kendrick had a lot of women that would be called literally skank hoes around him, even at Luther and in some other situations. I actually confront about that because a bunch of people either said, no, you're going to go out to DC and see all the senators and congressmen, and congresswomen have a bunch of skank hoes around too. Well, I went out there and I didn't see that. All the senators I knew and I met a lot, and congresswomen in both parties made a big point of not having what would be called skank hoes around. And some of them actually had problems with one or two getting stuck in their offices that turned out to be assets that they couldn't get rid of. And some of them actually ended up resigning or quitting running for office and just leaving their jobs because they were tired of it and didn't want to deal with it if they could get rid of one. Because some of those people actually turn out to be the ones really running the show and really controlling everyone else, and they're psychopaths. So just remember that. Okay. So now I'm going to do this song. And notably, women can be scrubs too, and your friends can be scrubs too. And there's a lot of people that can actually be scrubs in your life and are just JD and take your money and time. That's really what the song is about, as opposed to the guy actually having money. Because some people, what they had, they just took from somebody else. So nobody needs to scrub around like that, right? Okay. Okay. don't know if you can hear that, but it might be better to hear me than the back music. A scrub is a guy that thinks he's fly, is also known as a buster. Always talking about what he wants and just sits on his broke ass. So, no, I don't want your number, no. I don't want to give you mine, and no. I don't want to beat you nowhere, no. I don't want none of your time, and no. I don't want no scrub. Scrub is a guy that can't get their love from me. Hanging on the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. I don't want no scrub. Scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging out the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. Well, a scrub, he's checking me, but his game is kind of weak, and I know that he cannot approach me. He's looking like tough, and he's looking like trash. Can't get with a deadbeat ass. So, no, I don't want your number, no. I don't want to give you mine, and no. I don't want to meet you nowhere, no. I don't want none of your time, and no. I don't want no scrub. Scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging out the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. I don't want no scrub. A scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging out the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. If you don't have a car, son, and you're walking, oh yes, son, I'm talking to you. If you live at home with your mama, oh yes, son, I'm talking to you. If you have a shorty that you don't show love, oh yes, son, I'm talking to you. Wanna get with me with no money? Oh no, I don't want no, no. Scrub. No. Scrub. No, no, no. Scrub. No, no. Scrub. No, no, no. I don't want no scrub. Scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging out the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. I don't want no scrub. A scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging out the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. See, if you can't actually expand my horizons, then that leaves you in the class with scrubs, never rising. I don't find it surprising that you don't have the G's to please me and bounce from here to the coast of overseas. So let me give you something to think about, and then date your mind with intentions to turn you out. Can't forget to focus on the picture in front of me. You as clear as DVD on digital TV screen. Satisfy my appetite with something spectacular. Check your vernacular. And then I'll get back to you. With diamond-like precision, insatiable is what I envision. Can detect acquisition from your friend's expedition. Mr. Big Willie, if you really want to know. Ask Chili. Could I be a silly hoe? Not really. T-Boss, all my senior readers are stepping on your feelas. But you don't hear me, though. No, I don't want no scrub. Scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging out the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. I don't want no scrub. A scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging out the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. And that is it. Although, I have to tell you one last thing. If you are concerned and saying, oh, she's released classified information about the problems with the Asian woman at the CIA, or was it even really the CIA, or was she actually just working in one of these contracting groups that's actually Russian, lying to everybody. Well, here's the thing, it already all came out in the report on Edward Snowden. And where did Edward Snowden actually come from? He started out of the CIA, been identified early there, they tried to report it, the HR department messed up, and he ended up at the NSA. So that's how that kind of thing happens. It's a thought project, just so you know. Have a good day.